Welcome to CS++, where we make computer science accessible to everyone. In this episode of CS101, we are going to answer the question, what are the parts of a computer? First, we have the CPU. This is short for Central Processing Unit. Now, you might be used to things like microcontrollers, where you might see the term MCU, which is not the Marvel Cinematic Universe in this case. This is the microcontroller unit, for example. But this is the thing that actually is the brains. This is the thing that actually does the data processing. Now, it needs somewhere to get data from and to store data. So generally speaking, we have, in addition to this, some form of short-term storage, for example, RAM. This is random access memory, and we're going to talk of RAM in terms of things that go away when you turn off the power. And you might see RAM kind of, you know, let's make a RAM module of some sort, and it's going to have some chips on it. We'll get into what exactly those are at some later video. Okay, so you've got some working memory. We're going to call this working memory as well. And then you've got some sort of permanent storage. This is the stuff that does persist. So our short-term storage, our temporary storage, our working memory, that does not persist when the computer is turned off, but the long-term storage does persist when the computer is turned off. And this is something that we would generally call a hard drive, perhaps. Now, I know that some people might refer to the entire computer as the hard drive back in the old days of having these desktop towers that we were used to seeing, but that's definitely not correct. And hard drive is a bit of an outdated term itself. Try to make a spinning disk with a read head here, but that is not normally how we use hard drives today or our long-term permanent storage. These are today, you would see the terms SSD, which is a solid state drive, or if you are particularly fortunate, although this is becoming more and more normal, you have NVMe, which is the non-volatile memory express controller interface. So that is another term that we should discuss. When I said it does not persist when the computer turns off, this is what we're going to refer to as volatile. And things that persist after the computer is turned off, this is non-volatile. Now, these three parts are technically all that is necessary to have a computer, basically. We need somewhere from which to get the work that we're going to do, and that is from our non-volatile storage, probably. And then we need something that does that work, which is the CPU. And then we need somewhere to actually work on this work, and that is our volatile memory, our RAM, our short-term storage. And you can do work. You can read input, you can process it, you can write it back. Now, this is a little bit limiting if we can't ever actually see the work that we've done. And so you're generally going to have something like a video card. And we're going to generally kind of refer to this as I/O or our display adapter, or specifically GPU stands for our graphics processing unit, kind of a play on CPU. So that basically sums it up. Now, you also need a way for all of these things to talk to each other. And that is the motherboard. It's going to be some piece of hardware. It's got some slots for peripherals. And in here, we might plug in our GPU. And it's going to have somewhere for the CPU. And it's going to have some slots for RAM. And it's going to have some sort of interface for our hard drive. And it so happens that I have a picture of one of these that we can talk about. Now, this is the insides of one of my computers. This is my personal PC that I use for a build system for my C++ projects, and I use it for gaming in some cases. So, breaking it down, you can see in the background here is the motherboard. And then I have the CPU with its cooling fans. And I have some RAM slotted right here. And then I have the GPU. And then something that you can't see very well is I have hard drive storage here. And I have a Blu-ray drive. And kind of hidden right here is an NVMe. So to make sure that you are following along here, you should notice that these things that I labeled as storage, these are non-volatile. And the thing that I labeled as RAM is volatile. And then finally, the parts that I did not mention is the power supply and a case to hold all of these things. Okay, so that sums up the parts of a computer and hopefully gives you some idea what each of their roles are in the computer itself. Let's go ahead and get to the homework assignment for this episode. So this is your homework assignment, and I want to state very clearly that neither one of these websites are sponsors. I have absolutely no affiliation with them. They're just websites that I'm familiar with. But the idea is go to Newegg or something like it and pick components, pick a motherboard, pick a CPU, pick some memory, pick a GPU, a case, a power supply, and see if you can build something with some storage that looks like it's going to work. This is just going to take time. It's a no-cost assignment. The idea is just to go and play and pick parts. And then if you are so inclined, go to a website such as Build My PC. Again, no affiliation, but something like this. And check the configuration and see if these are actually parts that are known to work together. I hope you have fun with that. Before I wrap this episode up, I should mention that in something like a cell phone, all of these parts have already been integrated for you, but they're all there. You have a graphics controller of some sort that can display to the screen on your cell phone. You've got a motherboard that has a CPU, RAM, and SSD storage built onto it. It all has a case, and it has its own power supply, the battery, and then a device to make sure that the battery power that it's getting is safe and stable for it to use. So, depending on what kind of device you're looking at, be it a Raspberry Pi or a cell phone where everything is integrated, or a desktop PC where you pick and place the parts yourself, or at least can, we still have all these same fundamental pieces in play.